You guys see this rock right here? You guys see how it's, yeah. You guys see how it's like perched up on this little pedestal? And it's kind of leaning one way, right? If you look around, you'll see a lot of them. There's like another one right there, perched on a little pedestal. There's another one right there. And they're all kind of leaning the same way. Any guesses as to why? Yeah, exactly, they're facing the sun. So what happens every day down here on the lower end of the glacier, it's melting, okay? All this water you see here, it's not rain runoff like in the mountains or anything like that. It's all, you know, this all used to be ice in the last like 10 minutes, all right? It's just continuously melting out here. So every day, all the ice melts a little bit, except for the ice that's behind these rocks being shaded by the sun, you know? So all the ice is melting a little bit. The ice just underneath bigger rocks doesn't really melt so fast. And so these rocks find themselves perched on this little pedestal. We call them table rocks for that. They're pretty precarious, like I said, and they can tip over really easily. So if you guys see some really big ones, try to stay away from them. You know, don't go sit on top of it or under it for a picture or something like that. It might slide. But pretty cool. Same goes for, let's see. Popular belief, there are no glacier ants. They don't build these cones. If you bust into them, it's all ice on the inside, you know? And if you take a look at a little piece here, you can take a look at that guy. You can see these little air bubbles in there, you know? Yeah, if you have AT&T, there's a cell tower. There is. Yeah, you get a little bit, and it insulates that ice and all the ice around it. Mm-hmm. And you get this little cone that sometimes they get pretty big, like this bigger cone right over there, or like this massive one, and all the dirt cone right over there. It's all just insulated with dirt and rocks and stuff. And, you know, so this cone is growing, but all the other ice is melting away. Now that really big cone there, you may have been wondering, like, you know, we always get questions about global warming and glaciers melting and this and that, and global warming is a really heated term, layered term, so I won't use it too much. But, yeah, we see a lot of melt down here on the lower end of the glacier, okay? That big cone there is only, like, 3 years old, all right? So, 4 years ago, the ice was above the top. Lose like 7 centimeters. Just clean off the top. All the white ice you get. 7 centimeters. in mind as we walk around that church today. You know, a lot of people ask, like, do we do a lot of damage walking around? And I pretty much say everything that I, like, you know, flush up and come and break with my ice axe, all that ice is going to melt out by the end of the day anyway. We do a lot more damage driving around in vans and doing all that stuff.
Thank you.
steps, you know, if I take this monster step like this, well, now I can't transfer my weight to that foot, and I have to, like, crawl up or something. So try to take nice small steps. Okay. Duck walk. P.A. Canard. Difference of ice here. This is kind of cool, actually. Like.